We're going to start with the song titled Old 100 and Hold On, which is a beautiful medley of spirituals. And Bryce is going to tell a little bit about the story, and Ed will follow along with the solo. Bryce, please.
Thank you for being here with us tonight. Our next song will be an Old 100. These 18th century moments were brought here from the shores of Africa and were set to whatever English or Christian words the slaves could hear and understand. They were heart-rendering pleas to God to help them overcome their harsh circumstances. One of the prominent hymn writers of the time was a man by the name of Dr. Isaac Watts. When the slaves would combine their moans with the Doc Watts hymn, they would call it lining or raising a hymn. The Old 100s were rarely sung nowadays, but arise by to sing for you one of our favorites titled, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah. Following that will be a song that carries a hidden message. You see, most all spirituals have a profound and hidden meaning in the music. During the slavery era, singing was encouraged because the slave owner found that the more the slave sang, the more work they produced. So they didn't pay much attention to the words. But oh, the words, coded to sound as if they were admonishing their fellow brothers and sisters to keep their eyes and minds in the fields they were plowing, when the real message was, don't give up, don't give in, and don't give out. For help is on the way, if you but hold on, just a little while longer. Arise and follow up, guide me, O thou great Jehovah, with hold on. Thank you. Guide me, O thou great Jehovah, pilgrim through this barren land.
Oh! keep me there. Never cross the line.